What's going on, everybody? This is a Swimbait rod and reel setup video. I'm going to show you exactly the setup you need to throw a Swimbait like this. This is a Perfect Head 5.5 on a 1/2 ounce True Lock head by True Bass Swimbaits. And as you can see, this one is a little chewed up from the day. But the rod I have this on is a 753 Dobbins XTC series. Granted, I know not everyone can get this caliber of rod. The key is to have a long enough rod, a 7.5 to a 7'8", to be able to take up line when you're making a really long cast with these bigger baits. And a lot of times you're hooking pretty big fish, so a longer rod allows you to have better control when fighting the fish. Now, Swimbait heads are a big piece of the puzzle. You want to make sure you have a good hook in there. This is a 5-aught must-add hook. It is super strong, and I think it's a 60-degree line tie. But back to the rod and reel. I have this on a 7.4 Corrado DC, throwing it on 16 T7 fluorocarbon. And this happened a few times today. If I didn't have this high speed gear ratio reel, I would have not been able to catch up to a few of these fish that hit my swim bait. I was reeling it along just like this, and all of a sudden it would go just like someone cut your line. Your line just fell, and I'm reeling, and all of a sudden I catch up to them. I crank probably 10, 12 times to catch up to a few of these fish. And if I had a 6-something to 1, I probably would not have gotten a hook in those things. So in those situations, the longer rod with a higher gear ratio allows you to catch up to those fish. And this was in a 10-foot or less situation. If I was fishing deeper, you know, say 18 to 25 feet, I will throw a 6-4 to 1, 6-8 to 1. But on average, if you can make yourself slow down with a 7.4, you're gonna hook more fish, and I think you're gonna like the results. So yeah, this is my setup for swim baits. I hope this helps.
Top button.